It is correct. It is true that in analysis we use to break the complex problem into the simpler part. But the thing is that the problem, any problem that we have in our hand, we will see one example also. Aishman is saying that while analytical writing is about breaking something apart and looking at pieces individually, synthesis is about putting ideas and information together to see an overall pattern how things come together. Okay, so I got your understanding and I got your point also. So let me explain the further thing about the analysis and synthesis. So the thing is that whenever we talk about any concept, okay, or any phenomena or any problem, the problem may be comprised of a single kind of a concept, single kind of a thing that needs to be solved, or a phenomena or a concept may be comprised of a single or one or two type of simpler concepts or a phenomena. But sometime what it happens that in order to see the phenomena, in order to see the concept, or in order to solve a problem, it is necessary to use different type of problem solving strategy, different type of suppose that we are trying to understand a phenomena or a concept, so it is necessary to understand the different sub concepts. For sake of example, very basic thing we will try to see that I want to understand the properties of different type of a quadrilateral. So in order to understand the different properties of a different type of a quadrilateral, the first thing I must know what is line and point is, line segment are there, what are the angles, how angles is formed, how to measure the angle, what are the different types of angle. We should also know that what are the parallel lines, what is the properties of parallel lines, and if a transversal will cut the parallel lines, what will happen and what will be the properties. Without understanding all those things, it will be very difficult to understand the properties of a different quadrilaterals. It will be difficult because when we talk about the different type of a quadrilateral, their properties are comprised of the properties of a line, angle, point, point bisector, and all those things. So, without understanding, we cannot understand. Or if we want to understand the different properties of a different type of a quadrilateral, we have to understand via this, with this, otherwise it will be difficult, or you may not understand also. So in the analysis, what we used to do, in order to understand a concept or in order to solve a problem, we used to break it down into its simpler constitute unit. We will break simpler, complex to simpler, and unknown to known, because a problem that I am not able to solve, that I am not knowing, so it is unknown. We will break into its simpler constituent unit. The unit will be its constituent, simpler. That I know. How we will break? That is known to me. So it will move from the unknown to known. The whole thing I was not knowing, but we will break it into a such a fashion that it will be known to me. So it is moving from unknown to known, complex to simple. I was not knowing about this, but it was complex for me. So complex to simple, and it will be a constituent unit. It will not like that, it will bring from somewhere else. It will be constituent unit of the complex problem. So that is the analysis. Why we used to do like that? Because we want to understand the phenomena. We want to understand the concept. We want to solve the problem. But as a whole, it is a complex. It may be like that. You may not be able to solve, or if you will be able to solve, it will be not a wise enough to solve by that method, because it will become a lengthy, complex, time consuming. So we used to break it down into simpler constituent unit. That is the analysis. Okay, the further characteristics we will see. But first we will see one example. So let us see. Is the whiteboard is visible?
Yes, sir.
Achha, so we will see this analysis approach in one proving a theorem. The theorem is that the opposite sum of the opposite देखा जाओ ना, देखा जाए वो दिखेगा. अभी भी नहीं दिख रहा है,
खाली व्हाइट बोर्ड पर
दिखा.
हाँ हाँ, व्हाइट बोर्ड ही मैं दिखा रहा हूँ. व्हाइट बोर्ड ही दिखा रहा हूँ. वी विल प्रूव वन थ्योरम दैट सम ऑफ इन सॉरी अपोजिट एंगल इन अ साइक्लिक क्वाड्रिलैटरल इज 180 डिग्री. Do you know what is the cyclic quadrilateral?
Yes, sir.
Anybody?
Yes, sir.
What is
all the angles are same. All the angles are same.
Ah.
Sir, all the angles are same. All the angles are same.
Then, na. Anyone? Others? एक दूसरे कोई लोग try कीजिए. I am using the whiteboard, so I may not be able to see your chat. So if possible, please speak. क्या क्या फिर से, can you repeat once again? Yes, you are very much right. ये पूरा तो सर्कल नहीं बना है, बट सपोज दैट दिस इज अ सर्कल एंड दिस इज इट्स सेंटर O, okay, and the cyclic quadrilaterals are those type of a quadrilateral whose every vertex edge will lie on the circumference of a circle. So this is the circle, and suppose that this is 4 point. We will add these 4 point and we will make a quadrilateral. This is A, this is B, this is C, this is D. We will add it to make it quadrilateral. So see, all the edges are lying on the circumference of a circle. Okay, so this ABCD quadrilateral is a cyclic quadrilateral. ये सब 9th 10th में पढ़ना था. आई थिंक यू हैव फॉरगेटन एवरीथिंग. ओके, सो दिस इज द साइक्लिक क्वाड्रिलेटरल. सो हियर वी हैव टू प्रूव दैट द अपोजिट साइड्स आर इक्वल. ओके, मंजा मिश्रा यू आर ज्वाइनिंग नाउ. देर वॉज अ इंटरनेट प्रॉब्लम. Okay, so here we have to prove that sum of angle A plus sum of angle C will be 180 degree. Or you can say angle D plus angle B is 180 degree. B is not written very well. I am writing with the mouse, so you have to see this. ये हो गया. This we have to prove. So it's a kind of a complex problem for me, and I am feeling the difficult to illustrate to prove this, that how the sum of opposite angle of a cyclic quadrilateral will be 180 degree. So what I will do, I will try to break it down into the simple thing that is known to me, because this is unknown. I don't know how it will be. I have to prove. So I will break it down into the known thing. And for breaking it into the known, what I will do, I will join this the diagonals. And after joining the diagonals, what I will get? 8 angles I will get. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So now something familiar I got. It is a triangle. So triangle's property we know. We know the triangle's property. And there is another one thing we know. Let us do by black. Okay, we know that this AB, BC, CD and AD is a chord of the circle. Chord, you know na? What is the chord?
Yes, sir.
Anybody?
Yes, sir.
Which one is the longest chord of the circle?
Diameter.
Yes, very good. And I expect that others should also reply, because and Asutosh, I am not demotivating you, but for giving the others chance, you should not reply for the next time. I am not demotivating, but others should also reply. So that these are the chord. And the one thing we know, that the angle inscribed by a chord at a different point of a circle is equal. For sake of example, I will show you here in a big form. It is a, suppose that it is a circle, however it is not looking like a circle, and suppose that this is the center and this is the A and B. Okay, so one may be like that, it may inscribe a angle on a circumference like that, and suppose that this is angle A. One may be like that, this is the another angle inscribed, suppose that this angle is 2. Another possibility may be like that, this is the another angle inscribed by this code, suppose that this is angle 3. Another may be like that, this is the inscribed, this is angle 4. So here n number of angle may be inscribed by a chord on its circumference. So all the angle means here in this particular case angle 1, 2, 3, 4, all angle will be equal. Okay, so this is the property. So we will use this property because this is known to me. Okay, so since this is known to me, so what I will do, suppose that for the chord AB, what are the angles? Angle 5 and angle 8. See, angle 5 and angle 8 is inscribed by this chord AB. So angle 5 plus angle 8 will be, sorry, not it is a plus, it will be equal. So it will be equal. Next we will move to BC. So for the BC, angle inscribed is angle 6 and angle 1. So angle 1 equal to angle 6. Next we will see the CD. So angle inscribed will be angle 4 and angle 2. So angle 2 is equal to angle 4. Then the for the AD, angle inscribed is angle 3 and angle 7. So angle 3 plus angle 7. So just see, I have broken down into its simpler constraint unit. So one breaking down it I did. Another breaking down which is known to me is that the sum of internal angle of a quadrilateral is 180 degree. So I will see the angle is angle A, angle B, angle C, angle D, and angle A is 1 plus 2, B is 3 plus 4, like that. So all adding all the angle means 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 will become 180 degree. So angle 1 plus angle 2 plus angle 3 plus angle 4 plus angle 5 plus angle 6 plus angle 7 plus angle 8 is equal to 360 degree. But we know that angle 5 and angle 8 is equal, 5 and 8. So for that I can write 2 angle 5. Again angle 1 and 6 is equal, so I can write 2 angle 1. So, 5, 1. Yes. So, this is over 1 and 6. 5 and 8 is also over. Sorry, we will, why we are going to that complex? We can do simply by this. See, in triangle, we will see just A, B, D. Okay. And we will see that another triangle is B, C, D. So it will be like that, angle 1 and angle 2 plus angle 3 plus angle 5. Okay, so since this angle 8 and 5 is equal, that's why it will have an equal vertex in both the triangle. This 8 and 5 happen, then for this 6 and 1 is equal, so it will be common for the both the triangles, and like that. So we will find, if we will see the commonality of the angle in the both the triangle, because every angle is equal to its corresponding angle that is inscribed by the same chord. So by looking this, we can find that this is divided into two half part, and the angle 1, angle sorry, it is angle 1 and 2, and angle 8 and 7 will be 180 degree, because this pair will constitute, and this pair will constitute 180 degree, and this pair will constitute another 180 degree. So this angle A plus 2 is nothing but the angle A, and angle 7 plus 8, this is nothing but the angle C. Okay, so by that we can arrived at 180 degree. Here the main point is to understand that in order to solve any problem, whenever we are solving any problem, and if it is a complex and you are not knowing what will be the solution, and it is difficult for you to proceed with the solution also, then we try to break the problem into a part, constituent part that is known to you, that you know. Okay, so by breaking down into the known simpler constituent unit, we can prove the complex problem also. So this method of proving a complex problem by breaking down into the simpler constant unit is known as the analysis method. Yes, diagonal need not to be passed through the center, but it was actually, I was also not showing that it is a passing through a center, but what to say, that due to the inappropriate drawing, it was looking like that it is a passing, because I will say it was looking like that it is a passing through the center. And the second thing, that whenever we were proving like that, we were drawing the diagonals, and we have divided into the 8 angles, and we have seen that the chord and its property in the, so nowhere we have taken into account the point, the center of the circle, we have not mentioned. It is just a matter of that I was drawing with this mouse, and it is not very much accurate drawing. Okay, so if it could have been drawn by the paper and pencil, so that may be very much accurate. So it was just a matter of inaccuracy in the drawing. Yes, it is need not to be passed through the center always. In some cases it may pass, if the all angles are equal, then it will pass. But if the angles are uneven, it is not equal, then it will not pass. It's correct, Motendu. Yes, so the only thing I just wanted to show, that how we use the analytic method, analysis method. You can use this method for a variety of a problem. that are complex and that can be solved by approaching to its simpler constraint unit. So in the variety of way it can be used. Even in the previous classes we have seen a problem like that, if there is a parallelogram, okay, there is a parallelogram, so the what was the then its a diagonal will divide the parallelogram into two congruent triangles. That one theorem we have seen in the previous class. That can also be proved by the analysis method, because whatever we are required to prove, it is unknown to me. Okay, and then we will break like that. We will draw a diagonal. That is also a condition. Then we will try to see the angle sum property of the triangle. Then we will see the congruency, rule of congruency of a triangle, and then by using the rules of a congruency we will show that the diagonal is dividing the quadrilateral into two parts. So like that we can do. So that is that. So now we will see that some of its property in very quickly, or any problem or any question if you have up to here you may ask. Any question?
No sir. No sir.
No question?
No sir.
Okay. Okay.
No sir.
Okay. So now we will see that the characteristics of this analysis method. The first characteristic is that here we use to move from unknown to known, because it is a method of breaking down. So we move from unknown to known. What is required to prove, that is unknown for us, and how we are approaching is that known to us. Okay, so it proceeds from the unknown to known, and it is a more psychological also, because in order to approach the unknown part of the problem, we are breaking down into the simpler constraint unit that is known to us, that we know. So in that way it is a very much helpful for the children also, because they are able to connect the different concept that they have learned in order to solve the problem. Connecting, they are able to connect. So it is a higher order thinking process also, because it requires a connecting a previously learned thing for solving a problem. That is the one of the characteristic. Here another thing is that it is used to prove the hypothesis. Hypothesis means the tentative solution that we assume. In this particular case that the example just now we have seen, it may be a kind of a hypothesis, because we were assuming that if there is a cyclic quadrilateral, then the opposite angle, sum of opposite angle will be 180 degree. So that we have hypothesized, but whether it's a true or false, we are supposed to check it. So in order to check, we have constructed something, we have linked with the previous knowledge that I have, and by those previous knowledge we have arrived to that was required to prove, that was unknown to us. In that sense, it also connects the known data or a given data to the unknown, because other things that we have did that was known to us, the properties of a chord and the other things, that was a known to us. The another thing is that when we use the analytic method, analysis for solving a problem. It develops a kind of discovery attitude, heuristic approach among the child, because the problem in hand that is required to solve is unknown, and whatever the known to the child is so many things. Because suppose that this is the problem from class 9. So up to the class 9, the student has undergone so many exposure, academic, non-academic, at a school, outside the school. So the lot of information, lot of concept is there in the child's mind. But the child has to decide which one will be more appropriate to be used here. Means how the problem should be broken down. It is not like that we will be breaking down only, but we have to also decide that which one we should use. Like that here it is required to use the properties of a chord and the angle inscribed on the circumference of the circle by the chord. So it inculcates the value of heuristic method and the discovery among the child, because they have to decide. That is the one of the basic characteristics of the analysis. The other thing is that when we talk about the analysis, it makes the child clear about the previously learned concept and a content, because that are being used here, and it also establishes the utility of those concept and a content that the child has learned previously. One thing is that it establishes the utility. Another thing is that it makes them more confident, because they are using it multiple time. So it motivates the learner also, because it gives them opportunity to use it multiple time. It gives them opportunity to use it, remember it. So it motivates them. It also strengthens their conception about the previously learned concept. Means out of whatever they have learned, they have to decide that which one should be used, like that. Here this analysis also gives them opportunity to assimilate the previously learned content, concepts, because more and more they will be using it, will be assimilating, and it will become as a permanent part of their learning. So these are the some of the basic characteristics of analysis method. And the other thing about the analysis method and the synthesis also, we will see in the some other classes. Okay, so I think we should stop this class here only. So if you have any question up to here, we may take now. Any question? Yes, please, you may ask now. Yes, no question. Hello. Okay, so shall we stop this class here?
Yes sir. Yes sir.
Okay, so thank you for being with me in this class. Have a nice day. Thank you.